Hey folks, Mr. Bullock here, and this geometry lesson is on properties from algebra, and we're going to have our first proof and statements on segments and angles. All right, let's go ahead and begin with this board problem. What's the next letter in the sequence? Okay, it goes from A, B, D, G, K, and looking at all these, I'm going to write the alphabet all the way up to Q, and then I'm just going to notice what's happening here. It went from A to B, and then jumped to D, and then jumped to G, and then jumped to K, so I underline them. See, there's no space, one space with the letter in between. All of a sudden it skipped two of them. Here it skipped three of them, so I'm going to assume it's going to skip four letters, and it's going to take me to P, so choice C. Okay, and then what conjecture can be made if John is older than Mark, Sue is older than John, and Betty is younger than Sue? I just made up imaginary ages for these guys, you guys. And since we started with John, I just let John be 10. And you can make John any age. I just chose 10, you guys. And it says John is older than Mark, so I made Mark some number less than 10, so I just made him 7. But any number you could have done. Then it says Sue is older than John, so if John's 10, Sue is 13. Then it says Betty is younger than Sue. So all I know is that Betty is less than 13. So I can see that Sue is the oldest one right here, given those numbers right there. You could have chose any numbers right there. I just wanted to make it a real problem so it wasn't so vague. All right, so properties from algebra and statements on segments and angles. Here we go, some theorems. Okay, so these are proven. Sometimes I'll show you the proofs. Most of the time I won't, because we won't have time, you guys. And we've seen this one come up a lot and a lot and a lot and a lot. Perpendicular lines form four right angles, you guys. So there's my two perpendicular lines right there, and they're forming four right angles right there, okay? So what this is saying is if line L is perpendicular to M, then the red stuff happens. This right angle, this right angle, this right angle, this right angle, okay? Forms four right angles. Easy enough. You've seen that before. Properties of equality. The addition property says if A equals B, then I can add the same number to both sides, then A plus, and I chose C, equals B plus C. So you can add anything to both sides. You guys done this in algebra. These are kind of duh, but because you've done it before in pre-algebra and algebra. Subtraction property just says you can subtract the same number from both sides. Multiplication property says you can multiply the same number to both sides, so I multiplied by C. Division property says I can divide by the same number on both sides. Now, whenever you divide, you guys, it's always going to say, the book is always going to say that denominator can't equal zero. Don't worry about that, you guys. You just can't have zero in the denominator, so don't worry about that. Let me go back. You just look at that part right there. Division property says you can divide both sides by the same number, except zero, okay? All right, substitution property, it's one of the most used properties, and it just says if A equals B, then you can, for any equation, you can substitute A in for B or B in for A into any equation, any inequality or expression, so as you need to, okay? Distribution property just says I can distribute this A times B and then A times C. And you've seen that before in your algebra class, okay? Or you can distribute it through the minus sign as well. Okay, symmetric property just says symmetric property, if A equals B, then B equals A. They just flip around the equal sign right there, okay? Reflexive property is one of the most used. Anything equals itself. So for example, you might want to say the length of AB equals the length of AB. Notice that there's nothing on top of that. From chapter 1, it said the length of AB. If it has a segment on top, then it has a congruence symbol instead of an equal sign. So segment AB is congruent to segment AB. Anything is equal or congruent to itself. Angle C is congruent to angle C. Okay? Transitive property says this. If A equals B and B equals C, then A equals C. Okay, so for example, if I'm the same age as Betty and Betty is the same age as Sue, then I am the same age as Sue. Okay, something like that. All right, so here's our first proof today. Write a reason for each step. So I'm going to baby step this. Now trust me, you guys, if you just go along, baby step with this and just pull down those walls that you're gonna. You can do this, and I can get you through this. So here's the first one, you guys. So that'll be given to you, and always your first statement is always given. Always, always. Okay. And your last statement is, well, no, not this one. I'm not going to do that yet. All right, so how come I can do that to both sides? Notice I have 3x plus 8, and then all of a sudden I have a plus 4 right here. Over here I have a negative 4x minus 34 plus 4. Can you see I added plus 4 to both sides? I can do that because of the addition property. Okay, we just added 4x to both sides. Okay, now here, what we did right here is we just combined like terms. So 3x plus 4x is 7x, and then negative 4x plus 4x, those cancel out, so I'm just left with negative 34. So they call it simplifying or combining like terms, okay? All right, okay, what about this one here? How come I can go subtract 8 from both sides? Well, that's just subtraction property. All right, see, you guys can do this, okay? And then simplifying again, so combining like terms, okay? And then what am I going to do here? Remember from algebra, you're going to divide both sides by 7, so that would be the division property. All right, okay, that'll be it for right now.